It's the near future, and a dystopian one. No one knows the year for sure anymore, because Kamala and Kanye have deemed chronological time culturally oppressive. Everyone now follows what's called chronoprogressive postmodern time, or CPT. The woke elite has taken over. They appropriated my culture and oppressed my people. And now, my only ally in this post-apocalyptic settlement is a man named Will Smith. Let's get this, shall we? Let's get this, Let's get this. You know, I've always believed it was the things you don't choose that make you who you are. Your city, your neighborhood, your family. People take pride in these things, like it was something they'd accomplished. And so, this story begins with the loss of a city's pride. After a dark and stormy hurricane named Katrina, in the wake of Katrina's wrath, the levees throughout the city of New Orleans had broke, causing floods and famine. Famine greater than the great potato famine of old Hibernia. A week later, during a telethon benefit co-hosted by a young budding entrepreneur, Jeffrey Bezos, and an aspiring musician named Kanye West. Seeing these people, so poor and so black, Kanye could not control himself anymore, and he spoke the truth to power.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
Facing backlash from the media, Kanye was determined to find a way to reach a broader, wider, whiter audience. And so he went on tour with a man named Bono. It was there that he felt inspired by the Irish gypsy and his mellifluous Celtic medleys in front of arenas of white people, chanting his name, singing his song. It made Kanye think back to his time in high school at the Bipolar School for Individual Education, known locally as BI. It was there that Kanye discovered himself with his favorite art teacher, Miss Lippy, and her favorite song, Mysterious Ways. The two had an encounter one day in the janitor's closet while he served detention for her. With her Irish eyes smiling up at him, he felt the warmth of other suns, Celtic suns. He felt the desire of an Irish gypsy as she moved in mysterious ways. From that day forward, Kanye knew he wanted to marry an Irish gypsy. After a brief hibernation in Dan Ryan Woods, he recorded a new album titled Graduation, a Celtic medley of arena rock, hip-hop, EDM, and soul, the soul of an Irish gypsy. Meanwhile, our hero, Jeffrey Bezos, was busy setting goals and achieving them, expanding his business globally and mastering the dark art of supply chain management. Unfortunately, soon after the release of Graduation, Kanye's mother had passed. Kanye was without a gypsy and without a mother. He chose to express himself on an album titled 808s and Heartbreak. Soon after, he fell deeper into a state of depression, ambushing a white woman on stage violently and sadistically and savagely. In 2010, an earthquake in the beautiful country of Haiti ravaged its people. Jeffrey Bezos and his company Amazon felt called to action. He built new schools, He felt corporations should be socially responsible, not just making profits, but also helping people and the planet too. After the violent attack on stage, Kanye fled the country to the island of Hawaii, where he recorded one of his most groundbreaking albums, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, an homage to the Irish gypsy he so yearned for in his lines. The love letter he wrote on the album's final song resonated round the world to an Irish gypsy named Kim Kardashian. The two fell in love and got married.
Uh-huh, honey.
Meanwhile, Jeffrey Bezos was developing a black cylinder of his own and saw Amazon's revenue skyrocket. Kanye's passion quickly turned to madness as he faced a choice, his people or his Irish gypsy Kim. Jeffrey Bezos and Amazon continued their meteoric rise, inviting Whole Foods into an equal partnership. After discovering Kim was not as Irish as she claimed,
today I seriously thought about killing you,
it seemed there was no turning back for Kanye. He retreated to a hideout in Wyoming, completely engulfed in his madness. Much like Kanye, Jeffrey Bezos' success eventually got to his head when he chose to dance the gypsy dance with a woman that made him feel alive once again. Kanye found himself alive once again as he bathed himself in the arms of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, releasing his own tribute album titled Jesus is King. As Kanye was bathing himself in the warm waters of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Jeffrey was on an interstellar mission for humanity. After a messy divorce, Kanye found himself once again gypsyless and motherless. He retreated to his cabin in the woods of Wyoming. It was there that he wrote a love letter, not to the Irish gypsy a decade ago, but to his mother,
Donda.
Soon after, Kanye organized a listening party for his new album at Soldier Field in Chicago as a tribute to his mother and hometown. It was there, in a replica of his childhood home, that he sat in a chair, not unlike the movie Get Out, and he set himself on fire, not unlike the movie Us. Then he exited the house like a phoenix rising from the ashes and proposed to his veiled bride waiting outside for him. Who was it? Who was the veiled bride? The veiled bride turned out not to be Ellie Kemper, as some suspected, but a man named Michael Flatley. Michael Flatley was perhaps the world's most famous Irish dancer ever to grace God's Celtic green earth. Kanye and Michael, in fact, attended high school about 2 miles apart. Michael has both the world record for fastest feet per second, and his Lord of the Dance gesture was later culturally appropriated by Usain Bolt, the second fastest man during that time period. Suddenly, the lights went out, and the song Spaceship began playing over the loudspeaker at Soldier Field. When the lights returned, a live presentation played out, with Kanye making an artistic statement juxtaposing the working conditions of Amazon with Jeffrey's decision to space travel. The imagery was striking, and the crowd was moved. It was pure art and pure Kanye. Then a spaceship emerged from over Soldier Field, and a beam of light burst onto the field, raising Chicago's native suns, Kanye and Michael, higher and higher into the spaceship, leaving the crowd stunned and wanting more as they flew away. The day became known as Interdependence Day. As you can see from these chevrons and circles, a very straightforward linear process emerged, starting with Hurricane Katrina, on to our hero, Jeffrey Bezos, then onto Kanye and his madness, and then onto Interdependence Day, a day which most scholars believe signaled a full-blown descent of society into the Dark Ages Renaissance period, which we will discuss in further detail next week. Questions? Thank you.
I wanna go to the moon. Don't leave so soon. How can I keep going?
window strap and we up. Never forget all the memories.
Oh, Kanye, I'm so proud of you for coming out. I'm so proud of us coming out together. Oh, Kanye, where are you taking me, dear hubby?
Yeah, relax. We're not married yet, babe. We moving into Congo Square first to plan the wedding.
Africa? Oh, Kanye, that's so romantic. Oh, it'll be just like the movies. It could be the last king of Scotland. I can be the last queen of Ireland. We can go to the Congo, the heart of darkness. Oh, Kanye.
Relax, babe. Congo Square's in a little place called New Orleans. I found the perfect venue at the intersection of race and religious.
Oh, that's so romantic. When is the wedding? When will we be married?
We're gonna do it on the weekend of St. Patrick's and St. Joseph's.
Oh, Kanye, two of the greatest saints. Oh, such a great choice, Kanye. It'll be a green and red wedding, like the green and red of Mayo. Oh, the green and red of Mayo. Quite raw craggy moor. Our shores on any mountains, and faith for Raggy Moore, and Raggy Moore. Just like that, Kanye.
Yeah, just like that, bae. Come on, let's walk. So what you think of this spaceship, babe?
Oh, Kanye, where did you get this spaceship? It must have cost a fortune.
I'm a genius, baby. What you think I've been working on?
Oh, I don't know. Music? The Donda album?
You think I worked a lot on that album? No, Michael. I got bigger and better plans for us. I'm about to become the Henry Ford of personal spacecraft. I'm gonna have George Jefferson moving like George Jetson. Because I'm a genius.
Oh, Kanye. You're such a lyrical wordsmith. Oh, Kanye. Oh, Kanye. Oh, everybody's talking about us, Kanye. They're calling us Flat Yay.
Flat Yay?
Yes, Flat Yay. You know, like my last name, and then at the end of your first name. So it's like you put it together, and it says Flat Yay.
Yeah, I get it. How are they gonna put your name first?
Well, it's our name, Kanye, now, no?
yeah, something like that.
God, I love you. I just want to grab you and hug you and kiss you.
Oh, baby, you drive me up a wall sometimes, but I love it. Come here into Connie's arms, my little tiny dancer.
Love you, Connie.
Smoking this gas just like it's some helium. I see her ass all in my periphery. Hopping in like an amphibian. She working that ass continuous. I'm working my plans ingenuous. I'm talking about mags and millions, man, that's Eminem. I got a monogamy smile. I do not know how I do how. I give all of my daughters, no doubt. It's been all about now until now. I've been keeping it quiet but loud. I've been keeping it private but proud. I've been treating the fire like flowers. I've been keeping it silent but pow.
And she bout to truck on the ground. Oh my God, she getting personal now. Oh my God, I'm about to skirt on the plow. Oh my God, she bout to slurp up a child. Blah. She bout to truck on the ground. Oh my God, she getting personal now. Oh my God, she threw her shirt in the crowd. Oh my God, she bout to surf in the crowd. Pop me a perk and I smoke me some loud. Oh my God, I'm getting personal now. Calling my phone and my service was down. Sorry, I ain't been on earth in a while. Pop me a perk and I smoke me some loud. Oh my God, I'm getting personal now. Calling my phone and my service was down. Sorry, I ain't been on earth in a while. I'm gonna sleep on this set till I drown. Oh my God, I'm getting thirsty. Now. I'm ballin' way too hard on this crowd. They better give me your personal file, damn.
I tell you what you should do, son.
Last dance, gentlemen.
Damn.
Got the body of a goddess. Got eyes but a big
girl. My God.
I see you, girl. She coming down from the ceiling. Yeah.
Your beauty is remarkable. What is your name, princess? Tell me your name.
My name, Crystal. But I go by Duchess of Durham.
How splendid. A duchess from the great colony of North Carolina. Allow myself to introduce myself. It is I, Hunter Biden, Grandmaster of the Sigma Kappa Fraternity, and proud son of President Joseph R. Biden.
You said president?
Yes, he is my father. Oh, Duchess of Durham, we must marry. We must marry at once.
All right.
Oh, how splendid. Come, join me for a celebration in the champagne room.
All right.
I give you this prayer, you run me some head, and then you go blow up a bit. She moved out of state.
You know, I have quite a few comrades who played lacrosse at Duke University. You have to introduce me. In due time, my Duchess, in due time. Oh, baby, throw it in a circle. How much does your father command? There shall be no price too great. No price too great, huh? Yes, we can marry wherever you want. In the jungles of Africa, in the mountains of Kenya, to the deepest waterfalls of Lake Victoria. Where, Crystal? Where, princess? Where?
Well, I'm from Durham originally, but my roots go back to Louisiana. The place called,
Oh, baby, your booty's got me lost like Nemo.
Apologies. The place called,
Ocala.
It's a plantation.
Outside New Orleans.
A plantation? How grand. Your family traces your lineage back to the antebellum era. Oh, how romantic. This shall be wonderful. It shall be a blue and white wedding. A royal wedding. A royal blue and white wedding. And it shall take place
at the Oak Alley Plantation.
Just outside of New Orleans, Louisiana. How charming. How whimsical.
Oh, Duchess of Durham, my bride-to-be. I must know more about you. Tell me more.
Well, it's $100 for some head and $200 for the whole thing. What you want?
Oh, baby, I'll take the whole thing.
About to go away. You made me forget about it anyway.